So, a very good afternoon, jury members. Today, the presentation topic of mine is social media network and jeopardizing the privacy and security. So, we know today is the cyber era that we are living in. So, the basic issues, first look at that. So, the basic issues that we are facing are the privacy of data, the data mining, virus attacks, and the third-party apps. So why I'm saying this? Because if you look at the statistical data of the cyber crimes that are going through in India, it is like 11.8% of surge that we have noticed in the year 2020. So that's a lot amount to gather, and it's the beginning. So if we just do not get aware and prevent ourselves from the cyber attacks, then the percentage might increase in the coming years, and with digitization it might rise up to a booming levels. So and also it has to be noticed that the most number of cyber crimes, the most prevalent was of online OTP and bank frauds, and it was followed with the cyber stalking and the other crimes as well. So the most cyber crime states, which the state which has the most cyber crimes is Uttar Pradesh, followed by Karnataka and the other states as well. So it's the present ground scenario, and if we are not going to take a step ahead of this, then we are surely going to be a impossible doom if we are not going to secure ourselves. So first of all is the privacy of data. When we are going into any app, we are just sharing our data, and since I am the generation which I am of, I was quite secure that I have to share my data, and I just checked what are the terms and conditions that I'm agreeing to. But when I look at my younger generations, I just look at that they're just ready to share their data. They just have to post one picture on Instagram and they share to anything of theirs. So there comes a very crucial step that your data is being, there is susceptibility of leakage of data to the individuals, right? So privacy of data is a very important step. Data mining. Now, once you have shared your data, if they it goes to another hands of malicious intent, surely the person will, or the person might get into your systems and get more of data and can harm you in any possible way. Similarly, the virus attacks, if your computer or your system or your mobile is susceptible to any of the attacks, then for sure, there is some person who is going or who is willing to harm you. He will just enter into your system and will harm you in any of the way. It will just mention any of the virus, malware, ransomware. So any of the attacks can be happen with you. So just, it's one of the most important thing to take note of. The fourth part that I'm going to discuss is the third party apps. When we are sharing the data, obviously the third party involvement are there with multiple apps. So they will just, there are chances that you are not able to get what the third party app might get into your data and how the data can be used by them. So one of these four issues are very important, and the legal issues behind all this. Legal issues because it's a very growing industry, and there is approximately $6.7 billion of industry, and it's booming. So there need to be stringent laws and very fast track judgment for any of the cases that are going with the cybersecurity. Now here I just shed the light upon the basic issues that we are facing with the cybersecurity. But now I'm going to discuss what about the social media network. Now, social media networks, since we have been there at our houses for more than 1.5 years and with the corona, and so most of the youth, although they were online classes, but they were susceptible to their phones. They were given their phones and there was open sharing of their feelings, their images and whatnot. So the social media network plays a very important role where your privacy and your security comes into play. First, and the major risk that one is imposed to is the identity theft. Like if you're going to share your data, the privacy issues come in and someone can just take your identity and just take some loan off that on the base, like posing you. So there's a very high possibility of identity theft when you are going to a social media channel. Now the other one is a whistleblower. Whistleblower is just what I got to know as I was going through the, as I was going to do the presentation. So whistleblower, when the office people or any of the personnel or students, they just get irritated or they get annoyed with any of their seniors or whatnot, they just randomize and they just go on to the social media network and they just throw out their feelings. So they think that people are going to just they console them and come to into play, but you never know what other person is thinking of. The other thing that I want to talk about is a romance scam. Once you are going on to the, going over your phone, you just notice that if you're looking out for love and you are looking out that no one will never deny love. Everyone likes to be loved. So if you are going out on your phone, you come across any other malicious intent, you just click on it and you make friends, then friends might, the lover that you are going to look for might not be the one who you are actually looking for. So romance scams are very, very they are going on to the very social medias like Facebook, Instagram, and other platforms as well. Cyber stalking is also one of the important point to note here, that if you are going on to a social media and the person who is going, who has to cause an harm to you, he will surely take a note of all the details that you are posting on the social media. I just read across a case that was like one person who loved a woman, and the woman was very active on Facebook. So she just posted every update of her and her child on the Facebook. So she was mentioning that she went to her school, she took her child, they were having ice cream, then went back home. So all the updates were there. And in the end, it led to the kidnapping of the person, whom he loved. So cyber stalking is also need to be mentioned, and the cyber bullying and cyber terrorism. So all these factors are very important when you are taking the social media leverage, and you need to know that it's not easy to post every of your happening that you are going on to the day, but you should be aware that whatever you are posting need to be taken care of. So what are the solutions, what you can do? So first solution is that you can just take a very strong password. Like, it should have this lowercase character, it should have uppercase characters, it should have special characters. So all the things that the Google tells you to do, you should do that, because it's only because of a benefit. So special characters and all these things need to be taken care of, and you should have a strong password. Second thing you can do is you have to think twice when you are going on to any app. You are allowing your permissions, you have to think twice, and you should check what all the permissions are. Third thing that you have to do is you have to enable the two-factor authentication service. It's a very important factor today. So if any of the person is trying to just get into your system, it will just ping on your device that yes, someone is being entering and you have allowed. If the two of factor is there, then you have a security code to take into the system. Now, what else you can just take care of? You can take care of your digital footprint, wherever you are going. So it's creating a digital footprint of yours, just like it's like physical footprints. So digital footprint is a very important factor. So wherever you are going, just keep a track that all your device, all your details can or are susceptible to be shared. So just be aware of that. The next thing that I should mention, that verify the request that you are having, and just only accept the ones, close ones that you know, because, and close on only ones that you know that you have verified, like you know the person. But if you're not able to know the person and you have a slight doubt that the person might not be the same, just ignore the request, or you can just ask the person as well. Next thing that we have to take care of, that all your data and all your files are taken in a backup. And if you are not using any of the very important data on the net, you just delete those files after creating a backup. So I think I am done with my presentation. So thank you, participants and the jury members, for listening. And if you have any questions, please, I'm open to questions. Thank you.